Ellie, do you think any friends are going to be home today?
Hey, hi, is anybody home today? You know, it's always a mystery what strange things when I try to wet my hair and smooth it down. See, that's sad. When you have your hair up all day and you pull it down and you think you're just gonna do like a praying hands method on your hair and it's gonna turn out good, forget it, friends. Just have a good imagination, you know. Anyway, I want to show you something because I'm packing up. Yes, I am. I'm going up to my man's house in Asheville, and I will be staying. I am what looks like calm, but I'm actually having a slight meltdown because I don't come out of my very strange cage easily. No, I don't. But I want to show you something before we leave because I was just watering. Ellie's like, "Water the plants." I was like, "Ma'am, those are microgreens." She said, "Whatever." So I wanted to show you what's going on, okay? But not before a song. And is anybody home today? In the middle of the day? What are y'all doing? Renata, what are you doing, girl? Have your kids gone back to school yet? I should stay to the topic so when people watch this afterwards, they're not like, I feel like I'm listening in on a three-way call, like a party line from the 1950s, you know? I was thinking the other day, like it was the good old days when it wasn't the good old days for me because I had no brother or sister and it was always my dad doing this. But I would be like telling my friend Pam, shh, I was on the phone, you know, rotary. And I would say, shh. And she would continue to, I said, shh. Because someone, you heard click, someone picked up the other line in the other room and they could listen in on your conversation way before the internet. See, those are the good old days, right? Anyway, so let's have a song and then I want you to come in there because I want you to see what I'm doing and how I'm going to leave these for a couple of days, at least one day. Okay, I'm not knowing, maybe two. I might come back today, I'm not sure. But anyway, and I want you to see, but not before a song. Shall we dance?
She was a black haired beauty with
big dark eyes.
Points on her own, sitting way up high. Way up
firm and high.
Hot glass of cold beer, with a whiskey. Out of the back seat of my 60 Chevy.
Are y'all dancing?
Without any clues.
Turn it up, Tanny.
Working on a dime move.
Stop. So let me show you what's going on. First of all, if you've not investigated and you don't know what's going on with broccoli microgreens slash sprouts, the thing is that there is so much more nutrition in the broccoli sprout than broccoli, okay? Like 10 to 40 times more depending on what veggie or leaves you're talking about. But when you're looking at microgreens, you have an additional approximately 10% more nutrition. Now, what's the difference? When we have broccoli seeds, they germinate, okay? So then they start to get a little tail and the seed jackets start to bust open. And then they start to get a little root coming out. And right there's when they're sprouting, okay? So then that's the sprouts. And you can eat them like that. You can even let them get a tiny little bit of green on there that's really nutritious like that. They're also very mild. You can freeze those and put them in your smoothies and you get about 200 more percent uptake of the sulforaphanes, which is a component in broccoli sprouts that will heal your dang life if you do it. I mean, not if you have them on a cheeseburger, but you see what I mean. Anyway, so the microgreens is when you let them get a little bit past that. It's when the baby plant starts to form, but not before, but before the true leaves, okay? So I want to show you what's going on with those and how that looks. I have a really easy setup, and I might not have time to do it now, but I'll eventually link all the things. Now, the growing trays I'm using are from bootstrapfarmer.com. They are the 2-inch bottom tray that is solid, meaning no strain holes. I have a pack of two with the 1-inch trays that have these strainer holes. right? Then I have the dome, the humidity dome for the top, and now I have the grow lights. These grow lights were about $22, and these are very impressive. I got these off of Amazon, and I don't have a brand, but they look like this, and they're LED grow lights, okay? And they're 50 watt, and they're cool to touch. You can have these on all night or even all day, and they're completely cool to touch because microgreens have a tendency to want to burn up quickly, right? So I'm going to show you what this looks like. Another thing, when you are doing sprouting or doing additional time for microgreens, and you're starting out with really little seeds, tiny seeds, you know, you can do chia seeds, you can do broccoli seeds, you could do fennel seeds, you could do the zesty mix from the Now brand, which I really like, radish seeds. All those things are very tiny. And what's the problem with that is those can go through. What you're wanting to do is you're wanting to get those germinated and going a little bit before you add those to the soil if you're going to use soil. But I am going soilless, naked, so to speak, because I really like the fact that there's no dirt. A lot of these things, like broccoli microgreens, have almost a root, and I want to show you something else. Remind me to show you why that's not mold or a fungus, but it's actually the netting or webbing of the root that is just the way it looks when it's on broccoli microgreens, okay? But anyway, so you could put dirt under those, but what I'm doing is I have a little mesh piece, okay? Almost like a screen. So therefore, once they were germinated, what I did with the broccoli seeds, I ordered those. You want to get organic broccoli seeds, and you can find those on Sprout House, which is where I got those. I've also got some from the Now brand, all capital, N-O-W. Many places you can get those, but you want to get a high quality seed, and don't buy these little, or I would suggest these little packets that are in the grocery store or your farmer's market that have like 20 seeds in there. No, I want all the seeds for the cheap price, right? Which is what I got, because all those were like $7. And I have some, the next ones I'm going to do, the next crop or batch are going to be the radish microgreens, which have the pinkish fuchsia tone shoots. Okay, then the green with the fuchsia trim leaves. Yes, they're very beautiful. And a little bit spicy, but more mild than radish. And I love them so much. But anyway, so I got those, and then I took what in this case was about a quarter cup, okay, you measure them out before you soak them or anything, a quarter cup of your broccoli seeds. I put those, covered them with pure water, meaning distilled water, for about 12 to 14 hours, okay? Then I drained those. Once they were drained, because then they're germinated, okay? If you're doing soaking, you could leave those in your jar with the mesh top, and you could just continue to rinse. Once or twice a day, you rinse, you stir to give them, make sure it's circulating well with the water. And I have some other videos on how to sprout, which you can actually see me do that, which is much better than just all these words flying out at you, I know. So anyway, what you're going to do, and then you would just continue to do that until there's sprouts in there. But when you want microgreens, you want to get this planted. You want to sow the seeds before they get to that stage, because then you have a bunch of tangled roots and all, and they're not going to lay, and the roots aren't going to go down like they should, and the shoots go up tall like they should. So I want to show you what that looks like. So join me in the kitchen, won't you? Now remember that this is the light I just got, and the broccoli microgreens have doubled in size in about 12 hours. That is no joke. And I had a different growing light before this one that was actually just a light, and it put off a little heat, and that was not ideal, but it was all I had. But now I have this, and it was about $22, okay? So let me show you. Come to the kitchen of love and light, and I will show you what this looks like. Now, oh, you know what? Did I bring, where are they? Oh, here they are. Okay, so here's what the setup looks like. It's over here to the side, which is out of my way, of course. Now, these are the grow lights, and let me show what they look like from this side, because they have a very sturdy clamp. This thing means business, okay? It also has this, which is your on and off light. You could do one, or you could do two. Also, they adjust very well. Do you see? You could stretch them all the way out. I felt like they did pretty good like this, okay? Now, after I leave, when I leave today, I'm going to take this off. But as you see, I have this about half open on the humidity release, okay? So this whole setup right here from Bootstrap Farmer, meaning the 2-inch tray, the pack of 2 1-inch strainer trays, which you only need one of those on there, but it was just convenient for me to set it there. That's why it's there. So one of these that's 2 inches, the pack of these two, which are 1 inch deep, and then this was about $30. This was $22. Now you might be saying, well, that's $50. It is, but a pack of broccoli microgreens organic, which these are because I'm using an ocean organic hydroponic spray on there, which I'll show you in a minute. A pack of about this big, okay, is $3. All right, we also have the seeds, which still I only use like, I don't know, 1/40th of the amount of seeds in there. So even with this right here, when you're looking at 3, 6, 9, how much would that be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Let's say 15 times even, let's say $3. How much is that? It's gonna easily pay for itself. Now let me show you this. Now down in here, this is what I'm talking about not using soil. When you have these tiny little seeds, which you see would be about, see them right there, that's the seed jackets, but they're gonna go through, obviously, these strainer holes, right? Because those are larger. So what I did was I got this mesh, and I will later on give you the links for these because I saw a really good price on a whole roll of this. It's like a screen mesh. You want to make sure not to get aluminum for really cheap, like $7. So you'll use it over and over. But you can't even see the screen now because the roots are grown through. Do you see it right there? Very thin, okay? Now, this is, look at that. Do y'all see that? I just watered these. Do y'all like this? Isn't that cool? And what you'll do is when you're ready to harvest, you basically could take a really sharp knife or scissors and you go right down here at the mesh. You could probably pull them out too. I'm not sure, I hadn't tried it yet, but I thought I'd just bring y'all along for the experiment of this and just show you how cool that is. And when we're ready to harvest these, I'll be able to hold it up and get a whole like media extravaganza on holding up the what was like 70s shag carpet of microgreens. What do y'all think? So does anybody have any questions on that while we're still in here? Hello, friends. So another thing is the reason you want to get a 2-pack of these is because when you first sow the seeds, which have been soaked, okay, and starting to germinate for about, say, 12 hours. When you sow those onto the mesh, if you have bigger seeds like mung beans, you're not gonna need that mesh, which is the last grow I showed you here on YouTube and on my Instagram if you don't follow me over there. But anyway, what you're gonna do is you're going to take this other piece, okay? After you sow the seeds, you just try to spread those evenly, which mine were kind of even and they're clearly coming up like sunshine. But anyway, what you want to do is take your other tray and you're not going to turn your lights on yet, and you're going to black it out, and you're going to put like a little microfiber towel or something on there and black that out. Does everybody understand? And you're going to leave that on there for about a day, and then you're going to bring it to the light. How does that sound? My hair is so stringy today. What? Does anybody have any questions on that? Wondering which microgreens have the most mild flavor. I feel like the broccoli sprouts, alfalfa sprouts, clover sprouts are all very mild. I want to show you too this other pack, which I just got. I got these off Amazon and they're organic. These were like $8, and you have to see, let me show you compared to one of these packs, which is ridiculous. Okay, this is purple kohlrabi, and so you see the tiny pack of this seeds that was $3.99. Do you see this? Somebody gave me this. Do you see? Okay, that's nothing. I mean, this is great if you're gonna like want like a little maracas or something while you're dancing. But besides that, and they're really showing it like doing it in a sprouter tray. $4? I don't think so. How many? That is 10 grams. This does not even go in grams because it's a dang pound of radish sprouts. Red Arrow radish sprouts, which give you the kind of fuchsia tone shoots from the roots to the leaves. And come on, okay? And these were like $8, so you see what I'm saying. Like, be smart, you know? These are from Mountain Valley Seed Company, and they even have a little resealable zipper top. What do y'all think? So, does anybody have any questions? And so today, when I'm going to Greg's, I'm gonna water those again really good, and I'm gonna think about if I wanna leave that dome on or not, because once they're that size, you're really not trying to trap in too much humidity, okay? So, I'll probably leave them off and just leave one of the lights on and back it up just a little bit. But those lights are totally cool to touch. I don't feel like you got to see those good, but, and I'm not gonna show this again, because y'all gonna be like, we saw that, girl. But anyway, look. So you see, like, they're completely cool to touch, and they, see, they look like this. Are y'all impressed? There, I just really think those are great. And, you know, once you start to squeeze out other things that aren't serving you, and you allow health to be your hobby, you can get excited about these kind of things. You can get excited about, you might be like, well, Tanya, my family doesn't eat like that. Okay, neither does mine. Carly and Griffin, and they don't live with me. Everybody else thinks what I do is a joke. That's really true. So, Greg doesn't act like it's a joke, but he's really, I mean, I could throw some sprouts in his smoothie. He will have a smoothie. He's working on it, okay? So, but anyway, the point is, and if you have children, it's a great thing to get them on board with. Also, you can add, I mean, even if there's, say for example, they're having a white Kaiser bun. I know. And then you have mayonnaise on there. Duke's, no duh, you live in the South. You've got a little honey mustard on there. You've got a quarter pound Angus beef burger on there with some what were like caramelized acrylamide onions that, okay. And then you've got, it wasn't a health meal, but you did add this gigantic amount of sprouts on there. Do you realize how that's gonna really help your family to digest that? How they're gonna be getting in some actual live food so they can still have a live body if they'll stop that mess they're doing? You know, I mean, it's really adding that into what they're doing. Maybe they're having like a clam chowder soup and they're walking by there getting everything and you're just like putting them on there as they go by, and it can help you first of all feel a little better and not like, well, you know, I'm serving them death and I'm serving myself life. Listen, if you don't serve them death, they're going to go down to the Del Taco and get a taco le puke and they're going to eat that. Like, you're not stopping people. You think, oh well, I'm not going to the Thanksgiving celebration because people serve roast beast. Yes, they do. And unless you go or not, they're eating roast beast. You ain't stopping them. They're having a sweet potato pie. They're having all that stuff. Yes, they are. And if you go, you could actually have the ability to shine your light, and people might not say anything, and they might act like they don't notice it, but they do. And they could be thinking, dang, that girl was looking good and feeling good. And I feel like I'm dying. What's going on with that? I mean, but if you don't even show your face, then what are you gonna do? You know, you have no ability then. What do you think? Do you use regular greens in conjunction with microgreens? Yes, I like to have all the greens all the dang time. So let's say you're gonna have a big salad. You want me to show what's in the fridge? You're gonna have a big salad. You're gonna have microgreens mixed in there. Obviously you can add those to anything. I'll tell you what would be good. Let's say you're doing a big salad, you got sweet taters, maybe you're having cooked sweet tater or your loved one is, and you're adding, you know, a little healthier butter to that. You're adding a little bit of spiciness. Maybe you've got some Cajun seasoning by Frontier Brand. And then you've got some really like sweet sprouts on there. Or you have some very like juicerific sprouts like mung bean microgreens. Yeah, let's look at that. Let me show you. Look, you're just every place today. Come to the fridge, will you? So in the fridge, I was just making this up because I have no groceries left. and I was just seeing what was left in the fridge. So let me just show you. This could be added with the dressing, and look how beautiful this is. Do y'all see that? So basically, you've got some peppers, you have heirloom tomatoes, you have broccoli sprouts, you have mung bean microgreens, all right there, and all you gotta do is add a dressing. And let me tell you what I did. This is not a Debbie Meyer green box, but it is a box, so it does let the off gases of fruits, veggies, or greens out of the box, but it doesn't right here. So what you wanna do is make sure, if you're gonna use a box like this, that you don't put anything on top of that, because then it's not going to work. But my other ones are all stocked up. So anyway, and you just set that in there for later, huh? And you just cap it up. What do y'all think? So let me show you one other thing over here about the roots. Whoever reminded me of that, thank you. And so I saw some of these on here earlier in my group. We were looking around, and we saw some. I don't see too many in there. Oh, okay. Do you see right there how that looks like it could be mold? Do y'all see? See that little fuzziness? It's kind of hard for y'all to see, but okay, right there's some too, just like a fuzziness. You can really see on the edge. I don't have a lot of it going on right now, but right there. You see that? And you could think that's mold. It's not, it's how they look. And microgreens, when they're at this stage, especially broccoli, it has a little bit of a pungent smell to it. And you might think like that's going bad, but it's not, really it's not. So one thing about microgreens is they like to have, they like the humidity to be able to escape. So you don't want to put those like in my laundry room. There's no air or heat out there. And Ellie doesn't like it at all. But anyway, you wouldn't want to grow them out there. Just like you don't want to put your dehydrator in that situation, because it's trying to dry things out. And if you live in South Carolina, it's humid here, right? So you want the temperature in your house to be between like 68 and I believe it said 77. So you don't want it to be too hot, because they can mold, okay? You thought your microgreens were gone bad. I just had a sulfur smell from the broccoli. It's an odd smell. And even Griffin, Carly and Griffin are growing mung bean microgreens. They're on that stage because, see, I'm learning all these things as I've been sprouting for years, decades, but the microgreens really have come into my vision, and I've just learned so much that it would be irresponsible for me not to be bringing those in every day. And every day I'm having those. Every day I'm having half a cup minimum of broccoli microgreens and other microgreens. But every day, you can easily add those into a smoothie. They may be the most nutritious greens you can get on the planet, okay? So there's been a lot of studies by Rhonda Patrick. She is a longevity scientist. You're not gonna like everything she has to say, but she has a lot of data and has dug deep into the work of the sulforaphanes and how they can really help even have a more potent effect on people with depression and anxiety, and lowering that than Prozac and these other medications that actually have such a kickback of other bad effects that it's not worth it for you, you know. Also, the cognitive tests on children with learning disabilities have been improved with just like, this was like not even a fourth of a cup of the broccoli microgreens each day. Their cognitive skills, and I want to think it was, I was telling this the other day, it was either autistic children, I believe that's correct, 30% within just a few weeks did they have better scores on these tests. It's a big deal. Really regenerating your body. And when everybody else is like, well, you know, that's great, and they're having whatever, let people eat what they want to eat. Do you want to regenerate and heal and thrive? Yes, you do. Then do all the things. You know, feel good. And if you don't feel like doing it, do it now so you will feel like it. Don't wait till you feel like it to do it. Don't wait till you feel like it to get up off your hiney and bounce. You know, do it so you feel like it. There's never going to be a space and time on this planet where something isn't going on. I have some devastating things going on in my life right now, and I also have some very brilliant things. I'm clearly getting married. I'm going, if y'all didn't know, I'm going to the Hippocrates Health Institute in September, and my September to Remember Raw Reset will be joining me. Also, I'm going to Italy with Greg and a tour he's doing there in October. And then in November and December, we're going to be traveling for holidays, and the family's coming along. I mean, my mom's not on board with that yet, but she will be. And then in January, I'm getting married. And right near Morocco, and yes, I am. And so we're planning that today, and we're probably going to be working with a wedding planner. It's be like an elope situation, but we could either get married in like this cave where they do all the candlelight. It could be like ocean and cliffside. It could be in this kind of venue where there's like these balconies overlooking. And moving forward with your life, now's the time. Why are you waiting to proceed with your life? Why are you waiting until proceed as if you are the one who is healed? Because you're the one who's healing. My neighbor came over here today, and she had found out about me over at a natural food store, and she was saying something to the lady. She said, you know, I think that Tanny moved in that neighborhood. And she said, who? And the lady was telling her, and she started following my media. And her name's Jan, and we had the greatest conversation, and she's a yoga instructor, and she has been whole food, plant-based, SOS free, salt, oil, sugar free for quite a while, and she's still not healing some of her arthritis and some degenerative diseases. And I was saying to her how really healing is real. What's the next level for her? And she really was able to pick up the truth coming from the sound of the tone of confidence in that, and the true look of healing in my eyes, and the feeling of love. Because when I say that, I really mean it, because I've experienced it and I've seen it with hundreds, if not thousands, of people at this point. And health is your birthright. Did you know? So growing the microgreens, I mean, you can see it like, well, you go to a party, you go to all these events, you know, school starting, there's a lot of stress, all these things. Well, I guess you can't eat that. You can't go here. I can eat anything I want. I can drink anything I want, and I can think any thought I want. But why would I choose anything that doesn't allow me to stay on the butterfly vibration where I ride? I wouldn't. But I love the thought that I can eat anything, right? I can go anywhere and I can do anything, you know? And anyway, so I thought that was really exciting. That was such a profound conversation with her that's very rare here in my parts of South Carolina. And she lives right next door. And be ready to shine your light, because you never know. Usually you're like a lighthouse, and there's a really scary storm from you all the way out into the dark ocean. And the people right around the base of your lighthouse, your family, your friends, your coworkers, you know, these are the people in your neighborhood. They won't even see the light. They're in the shadow tones. But way out there, somebody looking to receive your light will catch that strong and bright, and you can make a difference in someone's life. And what makes you feel more alive than giving love? Nothing. Nothing makes you feel more alive than having a purpose in this world. You know? And every person has that. You know? Every person. My mom was just speaking to Carly about something, and Carly was like, well, it doesn't matter if the person is my age or I have a story to tell. I have a light to shine. And that's so true. I work with people my children's age all the time and even younger. And does Christopher pick up anything that I'm laying down? No, maybe he is, I'm not sure. But other people will. And then other people I talk to that are like 65, 75, 80 that say, is it too late? It's never too late as long as you've got a breath to breathe. You know, as long as you're breathing in air, as long as you're thinking that thought, is it too late? No, my friend, it's not too late. I was 30 years old when I got on a health journey of becoming what is a very strong constitution of health now, and I was dying then. I was riddled with a long list of autoimmune disease, cocooned in a shell of fat and poisoned body. And you can hear about that healing story on my website, TannyRaw.com. I have a little like, hey, it's me, Tanny, and I'm just, it's there for you. Because that's encouraging. You know, and I had tried for like 5 years, from 30 to 35, to scoot around and try to figure out what to do. And I was whole food, plant-based, vegan, but I wasn't healing until I was. And I devised a context for myself, a strategy, a plan that to other people seemed restrictive, but oh my friends, it's freeing. Because being healed is free. Having a strong constitution of body, mind, and then soul and spirit is freedom. Everything else is a trap, Pinocchio, right? So think about that. So here I am about to turn 48 and I've never been healthier. My hair, even though it's not a great day today, has less gray every year, gets thicker every year. My eyes become stronger. My eyesight is still pristine. My skin requires less makeup. My teeth are getting stronger. My gums are actually, the gum is not receding. It's growing tighter, right? My nails grow stronger every year. It's phenomenal. It's right here for you. Would you like it? Health is your birthright. So might I lovingly suggest you get your microgreens on? Because sure, you could have a Pepsi Cola with peanuts. You could have a whole milk and dunk your moon pie in there. You could have my mom's specialty when I was a kid, which is bologna hats, which is you get an all beef, thick cut of Oscar Mayer bologna, and you put some oil in the pan, preferably Crisco. And you don't want to put slats in that. You don't want to, because what you want to do is you want to fry it. Really get a good gristle on there, nice acrylamides on that meat, you know, that actually is a cancer-causing processed meat. Really get it on high heat and cup it up, okay? Then, meanwhile, you're over here and you're making up some instant mashed potatoes, which aren't taters at all. They're starch, okay? They're potato starch. And what you want to do is you want to put whole milk in there and lots of butter, half stick even, and lots of salt in there too, in addition to the sodium that's the bologna cups, which are going to be the hats, okay? And you put those on an additional pan that's going to go into the oven that you've got on broil, right? Because you want to really get it good and charred. So then you put your several ladles of instant mashed potatoes in there. Then you take some cheese, several pieces of cheese. You know, the kind, even the imitation cheese or regular cheese, whichever, it's both going to kill you. And you peel that plastic off and you put it on there and you slide that in, you let it melt. So you can have bologna hats all dang day if you want. Because with that, you are creating death. Or you can create life. And at the end of the day, everything you choose, every bite you take, drink you drink, and thought you think, you're building health or you're tearing it down. With every choice you make is a vote for you or against you. And at the end of the day, we've said it before, you're the only person voting. That's powerful right there. What do you think? So I just want to show you that before we depart, and I will be in Asheville, and maybe we can make some videos, and if you're in the reset, I'll be seeing you there in the morning, and I might be back here. I can't be sure. I'm not coming. Look, you have to do different things. Expand yourself, would you? Do y'all have anything to say about that? Save this live chat on YouTube. This will load up after I'm done talking. It'll take it just a little bit of time. And when you rewatch, first of all, if it looks like my head's cut off and you only see this, what you want to do is just tap the screen and it pulls the whole head down, okay? Another thing is it'll say live chat underneath that, and you can tap on that. And you can either have it in full screen so you see the comments coming up like right here, okay, on my picture, or you can have it down below. And it's really great. And I love to come by back afterwards and see what people are saying. And ultimately, if ugly people are in the group, and they're not ugly, they're just having a bad day, okay? And they came into the cottage of love and light, and they didn't wipe their feet. And I don't even know they're here, see? I could delete their comments later, but really, why? Let live and let live. It doesn't affect me. Furthermore, it doesn't have to affect you. What do you think about that? Other people aren't going to understand you. They're not going to understand what you eat, what you think, what you do, and they don't need to understand you. It's not their journey, you know? Anything else to say? I wasn't healing until I was, Myra. And then within 8 months, see, this has been 18 years. In September, the 1st of September, well, I have been whole food, plant-based, vegan, high nutrient, no salt, no oil, no sugar, for 18 years. With the last 13, low, though everything you need, nothing you don't, fat, okay, raw vegan, for 13 years. There's no salt. I have, over the years, changed my game up from, I used to just try to drink Brita water. Then I went to the Berkey system. Now I've been on distilled water for over a year and a half now, thriving on that. So from 30 years old to 35 was a whole food plant-based vegan, high nutrient, okay? No salt, no oil, no sugar. From 35 to now almost 48 have I been raw. And that first section of time that I went raw, which was right after 35 years old, in 8 months had I healed, had I lost 86 to now 88 pounds and kept it off for 12 plus years. Kept what, do you say diseases in remission? No, I don't. I have healed. I am the one who has healed. Though at the same time, I don't hold on to that story as if it's my last landing place, because it's not. There's one thing to be a survivor. You got your victimhood, which is a bad place to be. That's where you don't want to take personal responsibility, and you expect somebody to come save you. Good luck with that. It's not happening. And that doesn't need to sound harsh, because it actually puts the ball in your court. It gives you control. So, during that 8 months, had I overcome all those diseases? I used to have nodular acne, to where I used to wish I lived in the foreign land where ladies wore like the scarves right there, you know, so you could only see my eyes, because the rest of my face was like cankered pizza sores. And over time, you still can see a slight discoloration a little bit. I have melasma really bad. I have a little bit, but it's all smooth. There's like nothing but skin. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Greg said to me, and it has said a couple times, and I've noticed it every time he said it, because it occurs to me that that could really be accurate, when he says, "You look the same without your makeup as with your makeup. Your skin is so pretty." And I'm like, what? You know? Because even as a young girl, when I got married, 21, I didn't know. My biggest concern was, how was I going to go on my honeymoon and take my makeup off? And I didn't, because I had to hide. You know? Tongue lesions, tongue sores, GI tracts to the highest power. Leaky gut syndrome, arthritis, lupus, IBS, leaky gut syndrome. All my hair had fallen out, about 3/4. Usually I say 2/3, and that's not even accurate. And healing is real. I don't know how else to explain it to people. But you have to stay the course. And you have to understand that you did not develop disease overnight. It might have seemed like it. But did Uncle Jed develop heart disease? Well, he just dropped dead of a heart attack. Nothing was wrong with him last week. You don't think his arteries were clogged last week? I'm going to guess they were. We feel like, oh, well, you know, it's just hereditary. It's in my family, you know. The reason it's in your family is because everybody in your dang family eats pork chops, mashed potatoes with gravy, biscuits with butter, you know, all those things. Pork and beans with fried fat back. You know, but now we got a society with can't even digest food. So now fruits and veggies are the enemy. Yeah, that's the answer. No, it's not. And you think you feel better because you get the toxic hit of the hormones and the adrenaline pumped into these animals as they're slaughtered. You feel like you feel a little better because you had a little energy hit. My friends, that's trickery. Right? You feel like you feel a little better because you can digest this sort of, well, it's still rotting in your guts. But you feel like that because you can't tolerate fiber anymore because your guts are so screwed up. And that's a fiberless existence. So what feeds the good bacteria in your guts is actually the prebiotic and the fiber. Fruits, veggies, greens, and most of all, microgreens, sprouts, living food, live enzyme. Rebuild your body from the ground up if you need to. And be thankful that you're in dis-ease right now. You know why? Because I will never forget how good it feels to feel good, because I know how it feels to be dying. You can't really help people until you have true empathy. How about my daughter? She helps people all the time. Not exactly like I do, but my daughter, is a teenage mom, and she is about to turn 23, and Griffin is about to turn 6. Do the math, won't you? Did I promote that? No, I didn't. Did we celebrate that at the time? No, like, that was what has become the light in our life. Because she has turned a situation that wasn't optimal at the time into the most beautiful life. Right? Everybody has things in their life, and if they don't look like they have that, if they're not tripping their way to success and sometimes slipping, they're doing two things. They're either, number one, not even trying to do different, therefore they don't have to fail. So they're not trying, or they're lying. Because we fail our way to success, yes we do. Right? And it really is that a diamond is formed under pressure. Strength is built from the breakdown of the muscles, right? You will be built by the slips and trips along the way when you're like, I can't do it. Why can't I just eat raw? I have a plan. Because you haven't been doing that your whole dang life. And it's rarely about the food. It's mostly about the mentality. It's mostly about, guess what? When you're eating raw food, whole food, plant-based, it's a little easier to dope yourself down out of reality like that. You can do it with raw food. Eat enough nuts and seeds. Eat enough cacao. Eat enough fat. Eat enough. Your vital force goes off of thinking and onto digesting. But you really get on a high nutrient, high water, low fat, raw food, vegan existence. There's nowhere to hide. And might I suggest that's where the gain is made. When you can sit through that, when you can sit through the fact that you're not really hungry, but right now is when you normally have ice cream. You could substitute that with banana ice cream. You could, all these things, great. You could also do the most powerful thing. Sit there and take it. Breathe and allow the feeling of those cravings coursing through you. Is that real? Yes, it is. Can people be addicted to food? They most certainly can. Not only the physical food, but also the mental aspect of it. The calming down, the hit in the brain from this toxic food. And there's nowhere to hide. And in the sound of that silence is the answer. That you can move past that. And even if you don't this time, write that down in your journal. Had ice cream at 3 o'clock. I didn't mean to do that. You, my food, guess what? Tanya, give me my food. Like that plant, I think its name was Seymour. What was that movie? Rocky Horror Picture Show? That might not be right. Feed me. That's what it's like. That's real. You know, a friend of mine was in the grocery store yesterday or the day before with her hubby, and he wanted to go down all the aisles. She had not eaten, and she thought she could handle it, and she stayed the course, but it wasn't easy. She did it. She absolutely did. All those things, her monkey mind started playing tricks on her. So, you know, why can't you? You know, the spoiled child in her. Hey, how about you? This isn't fair. I've had enough of this, and I want my share. Your share of what, disease? Your share of what, disease? Your share of what, the dope that's been doping you down all these years that you don't even see, the situations in your life that ain't working for you? I say do different, get different. I say start to make these promises to yourself and start to show up for those. Till you're like, wow, I really did that thing. I really stayed the course. That was a tricky time, and I did that. And you do that a few times, and you start to see yourself as the person who actually shows up. You're the person who can do the tricky things. And then what once seemed overwhelmingly difficult doesn't seem difficult. You've moved to the fact of only seeing it as different. And then after a while, it's not even different. It's your new ritualistic patterns. Are you picking up what I'm laying down? You can do this thing. Health can become your hobby. I'm fixing to get married. Greg doesn't really understand exactly what I do. He doesn't understand. He's very open to learning that. He clearly doesn't try to stop me from doing what I do. He is a very interested and very supportive. But I will be in a home where he and what will be my new extended family, which is 3 children, do not eat like me. And I will still do my thing. No matter what, I can go anywhere and do anything and be me. I arrive with a silent confidence of here I am. Here I am doing my thing no matter what. And when I leave, push myself away from the table, walk out of the whatever venue of music and bar and liquor and toys and all this stuff, I leave with my results intact and most of all, the integrity, my integrity to the promises I made to myself. And if you can't start living up to that stuff in your life, I don't think you can get ahead, because that's where it all starts, right there. That's the little hub of your success, you know? What do you think? Little shop of horrors, that's right. Tanya, that is correct. I'll look back and see what y'all are saying in a bit. It might give me some ideas for doing some little videos. If y'all had questions here, maybe I'll come while I'm in Asheville and we'll have some, a little answer to Q&A on there if you had some things you were asking me. And I hope that helped out, and I hope that you start to get your microgreens on. You could start with something as simple as this if you don't want to really expand so much into that expanse or doing all that yet. Okay, you get you some mung beans, which you can often find for cheap organic at the Asian market. You can get some lentils from 365 Organics over at Whole Foods. They're pretty cheap. What you want to do is you want to, or you could get the Zesty Mix from the Now brand, which is also very cheap and easy to grow. I'm telling you those because they're easy to sprout. You could order a pack of these off Amazon. I got about 6 or 8 of these for about $5 many years ago, okay? And they screw on the top of a mason jar. Or you could get one of these, which you can also get on Amazon for about $6. This is a 64 ounce. These typically go on 32 ounces, but it has the strainer lid and everything. These are really good. They're good for getting nice circulation in there, and you could get your sprouts and microgreens on. You could do that. You could get the mung beans for about $3 for a big pack. It's probably about half a pound. You're only gonna need about a tablespoon in this. Okay, they last a long time. So that'd be about $3. Let's say this is $6. And for $10, you can get yourself started. Health could become your hobby. Furthermore, you could just be feeling into the fact of going into the grocery store and you have a new mantra in your head, and it's, I eat plants. I eat plants. Or maybe you're still having animal products in your diet and you want to say to yourself, I eat whole foods. Because maybe instead of having, I don't know, some kind of chicken nugget byproduct, you got wild caught salmon, which I would also be reluctant of because most of those, you can put in a Pyrex dish at home and pour Coca-Cola on there, and you can watch the worms slash parasites crawl to the surface of the flesh of the fish you are fixing to consume. But let's say you're still bringing that in, and you say, I eat whole foods. Get off the processed foods, the Franken foods. That's toys. That's what's killing the world. And whatever it is, whatever step you are on, it's your, we're all the same. Did you know? Your next level is your next level, and my next level is my next level. We are the same getting to our next level. And why? Because when you take a little time for self-love and you take a little time to repair the degenerating body, mind, soul, and spirit you've been producing all these years, you can start having a little bit of self-love. You can start filling your cup a little bit, so therefore it can overflow onto others and you can give love. And I don't mean giving love with a side of resentment, because nobody likes that. Giving true love, and that's what it's all about. What can you give in this world, you know? So whatever it is you're doing, You could just be feeling in the difference when you go into the grocery store and you don't pick up 4 boxes of Little Debbie cakes. Or you go to, I don't know, maybe your kids are having a back to school pool party this week and you go to that and you don't choose to drink all the Coca-Cola. Or you don't, you could just watch yourself doing different. It's so powerful. You know? Anyway, just want to connect. And help that your birthright is the takeaway for today, you know? Greg and I met online, did you know? And I told that story before, but he's been divorced almost 10 years, I think. And I've been divorced since I was 41, and I'm almost 48. And he was gone about a year before that. So, and we had spent many years, he and his realm and me and my own, rebuilding ourselves and becoming whole. And it was really quite apparent when we met. We had chatted online over a text, just a couple of texts, and he was like, "Hey, I'd love to call. Could I call you on the phone?" I was like, "Sure." And he called. He said, "Okay, well, I'll call at whatever time," he said. And I said, "Okay." That minute on the dot, he called. And we talked for like an hour and a half. And he was going out of town for his job that weekend. And he said, "Well, I come to Spartanburg, that's my town, on Tuesday, and I'm doing a new thing there, and it'll be the first week I'm doing it," which was kind of ironic too, right? And he said, "That's a week I have my kids, but could you, you know, you want to get a hot tea or a coffee, or did you want to get something to eat, or we can meet?" I was like, "That'd be great." And the weekend went by, and I met him over at Panera, which is really close to me. And the minute I saw him walking towards me, I knew it was something special. And we sat there and talked nonstop for a couple of hours. And it's a love story, did you know? And I couldn't have had that before when I had poor health, because I had no self-love. And when you have no self-love, that's not when true love and real love is pulled to you. You know what I mean? And I see that so clearly. You know, the difference that I have in myself now, that I feel like I deserve true love because I feel like I really have that to give, you know? So it won't be long and we'll be married, and we've been together 6 months, and that will be a year that we've been together, and we will be married, and we will be together forever. It is a forever love story because we are committed to working things out together, you know, and going through the bumps in the road together, the highs and the lows and the good and bad, you know, like it should be. You know, it's just such a beautiful thing. And, you know, all that's happened, and rebuilding my health had all happened, and all those things that you all, even that have watched me on YouTube here for over 6 years, have seen. There's always something going on, and I never really, sometimes I don't come on and give all the nitpicky details of like what goes on with my children or my family or my, I mean, something's going on with my son now. That's not my story to tell, do you understand? But it is my story on my side. And I just know this, don't wait till everything is lined up, because you'll be waiting forever. When you can get on board with your health now, and then everything's easier. The wonderful things are more wonderful, and the sucky things are a little less sucky when you're strong, you know? So I love y'all. I hope you have a beautiful day, and I'll look at your comments afterwards. Thanks for hanging out. A little dancing and a little microgreen growing. I love you. Bye.